If you do work for Prime, you probably recognize this building. Wanna take a guess? Oh yeah. The Millennium Building. Well, today is not about this building. Might talk a little bit about it, but right now, it's about my first week orientation and my hiring process here at Prime. Another video, another moment I take to share my experience here in the United States, and a moment I also take to bless somebody out there who might need all this information. Well, here we go. My first week orientation and my commercial driving license preparation. But before I actually start into the subject, I want to take a minute to give grace to the Almighty God and my ancestors, and also especially thank all my family, friends and fans, like people, viewers, and those ones who have been encouraging me, you know, people who have been pushing me forward into achieving what I'm achieving right now. The coronavirus is still real, is actually real, and it's still happening. And getting into the trucking industry was a big decision that I had to take. It was a big move. It was a change that I have to accomplish. And well, we all know to change and to do something else is not easy. It's not an easy task to do, but I had to do it. I didn't have no problem at my job. It was a nice, good paying job, no beefing with them, but I had to do the move. I had three choices: whether to do IT or to continue with my nursing field, or to do trucking. Well, God had helped me and I decided to do trucking. And into the trucking, I've been with Prime. I went with Prime, and here the video about the first week orientation. I did the first day orientation, I did the second day orientation, and if you haven't watched that video, check it out in the list of my videos or in my video checklist, trucking industry. And over there, you actually go in depth on what happened on the first day and the second day. About the third day and moving forward, I didn't want to keep doing one video every day because it was actually time consuming, and I'm here working, it's a job. So today I'm not gonna go in depth about how I got to Prime, like how I actually started here. That's gonna be a whole other video, you know, videos to explain how I got my CDL permit, because to be at Prime, to come at Prime, and especially to the terminal where I was, because I'm not at the terminal where I was, I'm in a different terminal, and I would say here to be at Pittston, in PA, or in Utah, Texas, you have to have your CDL permit before they will take you in. But over here in Springfield, Missouri, at the headquarters of Prime, you can come in without the CDL permit, and they have a whole department that can help you in getting your permit once you are here. But I would advise anybody who want to get into the trucking industry to go ahead and have his CDL permit in his home state. That will speed up the process, drug tests and all that. But again, that is gonna be in a whole different videos. My first week orientation, the first and the second day, I'm not going in depth because I already done that in another video. But pretty much we did, it was all about the document review, like your documentation review, online, like computer classes and videos. It was about getting cleared. Like getting cleared is actually making sure that everything is correct. All the information you submitted online is actually accurate with what with who you are. And you know, you're talking about background check, talking about drug tests and work history and all that type of. So they went and double check on all that. And once they do confirm everything is correct and good to go, bang, you are cleared. And I won't lie to you, it's actually oof, that waiting, you know, having your mate or your co-worker being cleared, and you ask yourself, what is taking so long? I submitted all my documents, everything is good. I don't do no drug. And then drug, it's gonna be another video. Work history is gonna be another video. Background check is gonna be another video. Like if you've been a criminal or if you have any criminal background, yeah, that should not hold you from becoming a trucker. No, but that's not about it today. So we did our first day, our second day, and on the third day I got clear. And when I got clear, I then was paired with an instructor for 2 weeks. And that instructor task is actually for him to show me the basics, like to help me through from not just having my CDL permit, which is temporary, but to have my official commercial driving license, class A, because I'm doing class A trucking. So he's helping me to get that. And as far as helping me, he's teaching me with some notes. I'm learning how to do the pre-trip, how to do the backing, how to drive on the road, and the pre-trip, like the pre-trip inspection, actually is, you know, check your engine, your in-cab inspection, your light inspection, the couplings inspection, to check your trailers, your trailer. Also, more really important, to be able to do your brake test, okay? The brake test is something that you don't want to fail, according to what I've heard, and I'm really putting myself 100% into learning all that. So the pre-trip is something you wanna perfectly know, like you wanna memorize if you can, depending on your state, depending on the requirement of that state. I'm gonna take my test in Pennsylvania, so I'll go with the Department of Transportation, DOT, requirement test. And it's about pre-trip inspection. Again, so some of those who has been in the industry will know about properly mounted, insecure, no abrasion, bruises, bulges. See, I'm still learning. No abrasion, bulges, and cut, no leak, no curve, no not broken, or no failed to manufacturer specification. You know, all those type of those are the things that you're gonna learn when you get into this industry, or when you're actually trying to get or pass your CDL, your CDL. Also, the braking. He's teaching me how to do my inline braking, right forward and backward, driving forward and moving all the way the back. My braking, straight braking, which is called straight braking. My parallel braking, the offset, and also the alley dog. There are four different, backing. There are four different backing that he is teaching me how to do. But I was told that, you know, there's only three that is required to do. The straight backing is a must. Everybody do the straight backing. The parallel backing is either the left or the right parallel backing. The offset is either the left or the right offset, or the alley dog. So, and the alley dog is always on the left. There's no right. There's no right alley dog. So right now, he taught me how to do that. I won't say it's difficult, because you know it depends on how fast you learn and how the instructor teach you. what you're supposed to know. But the way my instructor taught me, it was really, really comprehensible. And it's a step-by-step process. Once he said, this is the first thing you do, the second thing you do, and bam, I always found myself into the spot, like right into the square. So I've been doing that, I've been practicing that, and it's been okay so far, it's been great so far, and it's not been perfect so far, but you know, it's a test. Again, it's gonna be 100% doing a test. So I'm doing my best to remember everything that he's teaching me, and I am going for that. And I want to say something also. Goal, G-O-A-L. Do not forget about this acronym, G-O-A-L, goal. And it actually means get out and look. Get out and look. So when you actually do your packing, you want to remember this. I think we are allowed to have to get out and look. And if you don't feel comfortable, get out and look. It's really important to do so. And you understand later, or when you get into the industry, or ask questions. And the last thing, and the third thing that he's teaching me how to do is actually the road test. The road driving, which on that day will be around 30 to 45 minutes, depending on traffic. That's how long the road test lasts on the day of the exam. But I've been driving now. It's been 3 days that we've been on the road. Oh yeah, I never drove a semi truck, but it's been 3 or 4 days now. Oof, I don't remember. I lost track of time, but it's been a couple of days that we drove. And we drove from the terminal in Pittston, Pennsylvania, all the way here to Springfield, Missouri, and it's still really long. It's 20 hours, 1,000 miles, 20 hours driving, and I did all those. I couldn't even believe my own self, but I did. And it's been amazing, you know. The more you do it, the more you get your hand on the wheel. But it's all about safety. All about safety. Prime will not stress enough about safety. Every time I watch their video, again because of coronavirus, I understand they will say, well, everybody stay safe, you know, please stay healthy, wash your hand, wash as much as you can your hand, stay away from people, like social distancing if you cannot be safe. And safety is their main priority, and quality. Safety, quality, on time delivery, compensation, bonuses, drivers recognitions. I've heard a lot about Prime, and so far I'm not disappointed being here. Really not disappointed, because I've seen free food. Again, I love food. Free food for 1 week, you know, the first week of orientation, the food was free. Breakfast, lunch, and dinner, 3 meals every day, free food. Yeah, they allow you to have a loan every week of $200 to take care of whatever that you want to take care of, not the bills at home, but again, the emergency that you might want to do, or the extra that you want to do, they give you a loan of $200 every week. And this is my second week so far. Again, I'm trying to save as much as I can, because you know, I'm out here, I don't know where I am, where I'm doing, I'm just driving. They will lodge you, they will put you in a hotel for free. Oh yeah, or you have the opportunity to sleep in the truck, or learn how to live in the truck. It's really important, for free. Right now I'm in the hotel here in Springfield, Missouri, and I would say it's not a 5-10 star hotel, but it's clean, it's decent, it's amazing. It's amazing. Really, I want to thank Mr. Robert Liu, the owner, the CEO and founder of Prime Inc. He's doing a really good job, because he make sure his team and him emphasize on the quality and the safety, you know, and give all this opportunity for somebody who want to change his life, who want to better his life, not being on the 9-to-5 schedule, or answering to yes sir all the time, and be on your own and do what you're supposed to do. Right, and again, right, but they allow you to have all the potential, and say, hey, just stay focused, learn, and keep America going. Again, because trucking industry keeps the economy and the society alive. So it's really important, and for that I really appreciate the all the effort that the Prime Inc. I don't know about all the other companies out there, because right now I'm at Prime. Maybe if I find myself somewhere else, I will do another video and talk about them too. Because again, Prime doesn't pay me for my videos or for all the positive things that I've seen so far. If I notice something that I don't really appreciate, I don't like, I'm definitely gonna mention it. But so far, I appreciate every single bit, every single moment that I'm here. The people, the atmosphere, the training, the time that they put into this, it's been an amazing experience. So if you want to change, if you want to do something else, if you don't even know what you want to do, I invite you to jump into this business, into this industry, into this career. It's amazing. And if you want to do so, I'm not, into it fully, like 100% yet, but I have one leg in, and I'm confident that by next week, when I go through my test, I will trifecta it. I will do really great. And if you want to come and you want to say, hey, I watched Petit Voyageur video and he was talking about Prime and this or that, if you want to mention me or are there in your application, why not? I'm open to ask to answer any question or to help you or to get people that I know I will meet to get you the answer that you need or the information that you need to get into the trucking business. But if you want to mention me in your application, like I said, I will not mind be a mentor. I will not mind be somebody who will hold your hand or who share the advice that I've learned throughout my time here into the industry. So all you gotta do, you don't need my name, just my driver code, DOTESE. That's all you need to know, or you need to refer me and yourself as somebody that you want to get into or somebody that you heard of. Just mention DOTESE. I said, hey, this worker at Prime was talking about this, and I'm interested. I want to know more. What are the steps? What should I do? What is next? Bug them, call them, and just go online, Prime Inc., and drop your application. Thank you for watching, and then hopefully I'm gonna drop more videos about, and my next video should be about how I did on the test. I really pray everything goes well and I start this career. I can't wait to officially drive Prime and be a trucker with my CDL. I will let you guys know how it went. And here are some pictures or videos and stuff that I came to discover here and at Prime. I'm gonna share right next after this video. Thank you for watching, and be ahead of the COVID-19, be ahead of the game, step up your game, comment down. Or, and again, I want to say it before I take you to this little tour. If you watch my second video in the trucking industry at Prime, I did a tour of the hotel, and I want to do another tour at this hotel, Campus Inn, owned by Prime Inc. It's owned by them, and they make sure all their drivers are safe and rested before they hit the road free. I'm about to do a quick tour for you all, for you to see how it looks here at Campus Inn in Springfield, Missouri. But before that, I want to ask all the truckers or people who actually are over the road, the people who travel a lot, what are those items that you collected over the road and over the years? I would love to know what you do, or in different states where when you sleep over there, what are your goals and stuff like that. Because I've been to 3 different states so far. We stopped at 3 different states where we slept over, and I didn't get Illinois, but I got Missouri. I don't know if you can read. This is Missouri, and this is West Virginia. It's really amazing out here. Like, it's really beautiful to be able to visit, and not visit, but to travel and see different things, meet different people. So I'm at 2 states right now, the keychain and then a lucky bead, call it lucky bead, discovery beads in the United States. So a quick tour, and comment down, like if you can, or comment your own experience, and more especially subscribe to the video, because I'm gonna drop more videos into this trucking business, and especially at Prime where I am right now. If you're interested, jump into the game. Do what is right, do what you're supposed to do. Change. It might be scary, but take your chances and do something else if you don't feel comfortable in everyday. Same old. Do something else. Peace, big up, and God bless you all. Let's take a tour and I should be out. So this is where I was. That's my table right there, my notes. Oh yeah, it's beautiful. There's the balcony, and that's the back of my window. You can see the trucks are there. This is the back of my room. It's a two bedroom, again, two queen size. It's a full size bed, and I'm here by myself again because of the coronavirus. We can put two drivers. They used to do two drivers at a time, but they can't do two. They don't do two drivers right now. That's a 32 inches, 48 maybe 10 inches TV, microwave. Now the old one, it's not a five star hotel, but really comfortable, clean. The drawers, ice thing, the board, the iron board, and this is the bathroom. Now, really clean, decent, can't complain at all. And that is me. Again, thank you for tuning in. God bless you, and come into the industry if you want to change. If you don't want to change, step up your game and do something. Be ahead of this coronavirus, because if you do not change, the coronavirus will change you, maybe in a negative way. I've decided to step up and do something else that might not be really, really affected directly by this pandemic, and I will always be working, always provide for my family, and probably make it a successful story. I did it. If I can do it, you can do it. Godspeed. See you in the next video. Petit voyageur.